so excited! I haven't recorded a video in so long and I'm so happy! I'm happy! Don't it always seem to go that you don't know what you've got till it's gone? Don't it always seem... Hey guys! So, little disclaimer before I get into this. Well, actually two disclaimers. First of all, this is for people with curly hair. If you do not have curly hair naturally, it's not... You're not gonna... Yeah. So for those of you who do not like videos where I talk a lot, I am going to warn you now, you might want to hit the exit because this is one of those videos. For those of you who actually care about what I have to say, this video is for you guys. Okay, so this video is probably going to be all over the place. So I'm going to start with products and I'm going to be very honest with you. So when I stopped using like gels and mousses and all that, I used creams, and this cream is the only cream, literally this is the only thing I used for like a good like 6 months. And it's the Garnier Fructis Sleek and Shine. And you can get this at Walmart. It's crazy cheap. It's like $2 or something. And this is literally the only product I use. And the reason being is because I was broke. I didn't have a job, so I had no money. And my mom was not about to spend $10 on one hair product for me. But here's the thing, it's not one of those products that's like, you know, sulfate free, paraben, all those silicones, all that. It's not that product. So if you're one of those people who are like really, really, really into the ingredients that you put in your hair, I wouldn't recommend this. This is what I use though, so I just wanted to tell you what I use. When I actually started getting more serious about my hair and I started saving my money and I decided that I wanted to spend a little bit of money on my products, that is when I started using this. It's literally gone. I use it to this day, although I think I need to lay off a little bit because my hair, I feel like, is getting used to it and it's not working as well as it used to. So the first ever like real curly hair products I bought was this curl enhancing smoothie, and then I also bought the curl and style milk, and the two products worked crazy good in my hair. Like, my hair loved it, and this is all I used for probably like 2 years, like this and the other products. And then I also used the matching shampoo and conditioner. So this whole coconut and hibiscus line is all I use. The first ever curly video I watched here on YouTube was Shameless Maya's curly hair routine. She made it like 4 or 5 years ago, and that's actually where I got the products. I will link that video below because it's a really, really good video. I feel like my hair is gonna catch on fire. Can you guys see this candle? It gets like right there. When I was transitioning, I was very, very, very simple with what I put in my hair. Literally, I use those two products and then I would seal it with coconut oil. I use those products until my hair got to how I wanted it. And then I started seeing more products that I like. I found Kinky Curly, not today. I haven't used that product in a very long time though. I'm sorry, this video is all over the place. Don't hate me. So here's the thing. When I first started transitioning, I would do twist outs, and I'm going to put a demonstration later on what I did, how I did it. But anyways, all I did was twist outs. Whenever I wore my hair down, it was a twist out. I did not wear my hair curly. I did not do like a wash and go. I didn't do none of that. Like, strictly twist outs or a bun, because my curls were just so gross and like I was just like, ugh. Once my hair actually got to a point to where I felt like it looked pretty decent without me doing a twist out, that's when I started incorporating the Kinky Curly product, and I started playing around more with products. I can't remember, after that it's just history, but I remember those are the first three real curly products that I used. Oh my gosh, was this there the whole time? What? You guys weren't gonna say anything to me? You just got me out here looking crazy. So for routine, I think it is important when transitioning to figure out a routine that you're gonna do. So whether you are planning on wearing it as a wash and go, or whether you're planning on doing protective styles or twist outs or bantu knots or braid outs, there are so many different things that you can do with your hair. I think you should experiment, find out what you like best, and you don't have to stick to one thing. You can honestly do all of them if that's what you want to do. But for me, it was just easier to do twist outs. And with my hair type and texture, it looked best with twist outs. I encourage you guys to find out a technique that works good for you if you are not comfortable with wearing your hair as a wash and go. I know it can be like really discouraging. This part is going to sound really redundant because I've said it in a lot of videos, but it is important and it is vital, and you have to follow these steps. It'll make it a whole lot easier for you. Deep conditioning. I have a whole video on deep conditioning if you're interested. I will link that below. Satin pillowcase, just use it. If you can't use it, a bonnet. They're like, what, a dollar maybe? Microfiber towel. I found one. If you follow me on Snapchat, I found them at the Dollar Tree for a dollar. I bought mine for like $7. So a dollar for a microfiber towel, that's great. If you can't use a microfiber towel, you can use a cotton t-shirt. You can use like a silk t-shirt. Just don't use a towel. All these things I know a lot of you guys already know, but there might be someone who doesn't know, or maybe you need a reminder. Comb. Don't brush it. Comb it. You guys know that. Bottom up. Started from the bottom. Then we're here. Yeah. You know, all of the basic curly rules, they're there for a reason. I know it can be like really redundant and like, really, I do all that, but you just do it. Once you establish like a routine and you get into habits, it's so easy. Like, you just do it without even thinking about it. Two things that are also important is figuring out your hair porosity and your hair type. There are tons of videos out there. I don't want to put everything in one video just because it will be a lot. And I can tell this video is already gonna be long anyway, so I'm not gonna do that. If you got it, just be like, girl, I got this. You ain't the only one with curly hair on YouTube, so chill out. Recovering your hair from whether it's heat damage, chemical damage, color, whatever it's simple, it's just really redundant, and it's really time consuming, and you have to have a lot of patience. Patience is everything, because you know, some people, it takes a year, 2 years, a very long time. So it could be really easy to get discouraged and be like, you know, forget this. I'm getting my straightener and I'm straightening my curls. That's the easy way. Don't take the easy way. Stick with it. I promise you. I promise you. It'll be worth it. You know, sometimes we just need a reminder. Sometimes we just need a little motivation. So I think I'm gonna stop talking now, but I am going to show how I do my twist outs, or I don't do them anymore, but how I did my twist out. I'll see you on the other side. Okay, so to start off, I start off by sectioning my hair, and I go horizontal rather than vertical because it looks a lot better when it dries. I'm doing this on freshly washed hair, but I'm just going to make sure that it is soaking because it turns out better like that. Next, I'm going in with my Curl and Style Milk, and I'm just going to rake that through. So to get a better idea of my curl pattern, I'm just going to rake it through. And then as you see, my curls go away from my face or back rather than forward. And this is very important when trying to train your curls. So next I'm going to get my curl enhancing smoothie, and I'm just going to smooth that through my hair. It's important to make sure you smooth the top so that it's not frizzy when it dries. Then I'm going to twist it back, and this helps a lot when you're trying to train your curls because it's kind of like you're boosting the curl. You know, you're training it to do what it does naturally. You're giving it like some help. It's important to make sure you follow your curl pattern rather than go against it. Then when I'm done, I just scrunch it up. So once my hair is completely dry, I take coconut oil. You can use any oil you prefer. I put that throughout my fingers, and then I gently separate the curls to make it fuller and more voluptuous. This is the result when it's done. As you can see, it's completely different from my natural curl pattern, but trust me, it helps when you're trying to train your curls. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time. Bye!